In Harinam and in Diksha, which is more important and prominent? Prabhu, Vaishnavananda Prabhu.
Harinam.
Why? Why? How?
The holy name of Krishna is not different from Krishna himself.
Yes. And other things?
He can give his Krishna a prem. Nam can give his Krishna a prem.
And? Mantra?
Diksha is mainly to clear away anarth.
Not only to clear anarth, but strengthen the relationship. Marriage is needed when there is no marriage, only it has been told that you will be married to that person. But if marriage is done, after that no ceremony, nothing is done, that he is my servant, he is my husband, always like them. But it's, up to that time, marriage is not done. A lady can think now, when we will be married, when we will be married. Very sweet thing will be. But after marriage, before marriage, if you are meeting to that new coming husband, that anyone can tell, oh, she's her character is not okay. But after marriage, no need of doing again marriage. So, when we are in sadhana, don't do all these things. So, if it is needed, mantra is needed in worldly sadhana, and if we have Sarup Siddhi, and after that we are coming to Vastu Siddhi. No need of this mantra. Then, my beloved, where you are, like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu called when he went to Jagannath Puri. Like this. Krishna mantra haita hai sansar mochan, Krishna naam haita pai Krishna prem dhan. Mochan means, what is the meaning of mochan? Where is Navdeep? Navdeep near, not here. Tum batla sakta hai, tum bhi baitha ka 5 mil dur. You will sit 5 miles away from me. But not to clear away. Without mantra we have no relation with Krishna. In this world, having this relationship and we can chant name, then we can purify more and have realized the all these things in sadhan dasa and in ripan matured dasa, it will come clearly everything. When mango is in not ripen, but pure, matured, not ripen, but matured, understand?
Yes, green.
Green?
Full, but not...
It has gone to his
shape.
But there is difference between ripen and between...
Unripen.
No taste. So, when we are practicing, everything we will do in this world. We will learn all these things. In Swarup Siddhi and in Vastu Siddhi, all will clear. And practically we will do this. Like very babies having two dolls, one lady and one woman, a man, they make marriage. Very little baby, they don't know what is marriage, but still they do. But doing so, when they are married, then everything they know. So practicing everything in sadhan dasa, sadhanate karibe jaha,
sadhane bhavibe jaha,
siddhite paibe taha. What you will think in sadhan, like I am friend of Krishna, I am following Siddham, Subal, Madhu, Mangal, I am obeying them, I am very beautiful shape of cowherd. And if he will give up this body thinking like so, a very good transcendental shape will come. You will have. And really, you will feel that. Like Bharat Maharaj, he was thinking of deer and left his body and he became deer. Why we will not? Surely. So in sadhan what we will think, in siddhi the same thing there. Ashtakali lila is, if you are doing and serving Krishna in a special mode, that special mode will come that after that. If you are obeying proper, in proper way. You should come here, always sit here, nearby. No? So, in sadhana avastha, abhakti, all our activities and all our cultivation are not actually bhakti, not sadhana. When we, our object is to have bhav bhakti, what we are cultivating, or all senses, by all senses,
practicing.
Then, having the mood that I will have bhav bhakti, then it will be sadhana. Otherwise, it is sadhana abhas. Sadhana abhas. Abhas, you know? Semblance of sadhana. Not actually sadhana. Because you don't know anything about sadhana and what is your goal. Knowing all your goals and how to cultivate your all senses of bhaktis, then it may be sadhana. And when the object of our mood, bhav bhakti, will be swarup siddhi, Krishna prem, then it will be bhav bhakti, otherwise not bhav bhakti. So we should clear all these things. Then we can proceed on sadhana. Otherwise we cannot do any sadhana. Only chanting will not do. Those who are chanting, some becomes like Mayavadi, some Sajiya, some has some worldly gains, some are involved in mukti, some go to Narayan Lok, some to Ayodhya, some to Dwarka, Mathura Puri, and among them so rare go to Krishna in Braja, and in them rare to Dasya Bhakti of Krishna, and in them rare to Krishna as a Sakha, Sridham Shubha. Very, very rare are like Nanda Baba and Yashoda, and very among them, very rare. What thing? Madhurya Rasa. And in them, very rare in the line of Rupa Goswami. So we are coming in this line of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Rupa Goswami. Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Jena Swayam Rupa Kada Mahiyam Dadapisa. Anyone knowing not all these things, uttering this sloka, he has no realization at all what the meaning of this sloka. What is this Swapadamptikam? He will not. So we must, I think, our classes are going well. Like East Goshti, you are free to question anything. I'm now beginning my Srimad Bhagavat class. In morning we will discuss about Upadeshamrita and all these teachings. How we can enter in bhakti. Also this will add it. It will make greed Bhagavatam. I want to clear one thing more. What is the basic difference between Gita and Bhagavatam? Some devotees have an opinion that I don't regard Gita. Myself, I disregard Gita. But this is the same thing with Swamiji, Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj. He had not disregarded, and I am also not going to disregard Gita. But sometimes I say like Swamiji, I have read anywhere, you may remember, that Gita is first book of devotion.
ABC.
Beginning. And Srimad Bhagavat, Bhagavatam?
Postgraduate.
PhD. Last book. Why he has told like so? He has disregarded Gita? By telling. This is the fact. But for beginners it is not told like so. Otherwise their faith, they will lose their faith. Na janayed karma sangina. Na buddhi bheda janayed karma sangina. Don't disturb karmi. They should gradually come towards devotional services. So something is told for them. Gita is essential because it is the ground. But you know, you should know this fact. Vyasadeva has divided Vedas in four Rig Veda, Sam Veda, Yadur Veda, Atharva Veda. He has explained Gita, Upanishads. He has done, compiled almost all 18th Purans, 18th Upapuran, 18th Shaka Puran, 36 Purans. He has done Mahabharata, 18th Parva, Parva, you know? Also Gita is 18th chapters of same Srimad Bhagavatam, of same Mahabharata. It was finished, it was compiled, but yet Vyasa was not satisfied. And he was not thinking that why I am not pleased, my Atma is not so happy, why? Gita was there, he has done in Mahabharata, and it was prominent, but yet why he was not satisfied? So Gita was there, but he was not satisfied. But when Srimad Bhagavat was compiled, then he became happy. But there is something lacking in Gita. It is for beginners, no doubt. But for advanced, nothing is there. There is only Saranagati, which is the door of bhakti. The door is not itself bhakti, but it gives entrance in bhakti realm. And that is why, you know, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told that sarva-dharman pratyajam, he told that, oh, it is bahya. It is?
External.
That is why. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was dishonoring Gita by telling this. What he was telling, doing? So, doing comparison is not bad thing, not dishonoring. When we will tell that Ram, Krishna is supreme personality of Godhead. Ram is same by Siddhanta. Siddhanta tas abhede api Krishna
saparupayo
rasen utkrishyate Krishna upamesha rasasthiti. By rasa, Krishna is supreme. So this is not dishonoring Ram, not dishonoring Mahavishnu or Dwarkadhish by telling this. So Swamiji Maharaj has not dishonored Gita, because in itself in Srimad Bhagavata it is written that he was not happy. He was lacking something. At that time Gita was done, Mahabharata was done, still he was not happy. So there is something lacking. No prem there. How to develop Krishna consciousness? Prem, this system is not there. Only out external things, like doing Saranagati, giving all, knowing tattva, established in that. This is the main object of Gita, that we are not this body, we are not mind, we are part and parcel of Krishna. And it has not been clearly said that. It has been told, but in a covered way. What has been told in Srimad Bhagavat and Chaitanya Chaitamrita, very vividly, in the dialogue of Sanatana Goswami, everything is clear. That in Gita it is not clear. How to love Krishna? It is not all there. That is why we are coming to conclusion by Srimad Bhagavatam. For Srimad Bhagavat it has been told that Nigamakalpataror Galitanga Phalam Sukamukhad Amrita Dava Sanjutam पिबत भागवतम रसमालयम मुहुरहो ऋषिका भूभाविका. फॉर गीता इट हैज बीन टोल्ड सर्व उपनिषदो गावो दुग्धा गोपाल नंदन पार्थो वत्स सुधीर भोक्ता गीता अमृतम महत. कंपेयर दिस श्लोक. फॉर द ग्लोरिफिकेशन ऑफ गीता इट हैज बीन टोल्ड सर्व उपनिषदो गावो. All the Upanishads are like cows. Krishna is milkman. And Vatsavane, calf is Arjun. Arjun is in the place of calves. Milk is not, all milk is not for calves. Malnisham and other milks is for Sudhir, Bhokta, those who are Sudhi. Shuddhi means bhakta. Their buddhi is so sthir. Wisdom is sthir. Mind is established, not going anywhere. That they want to become bhakta. They want to come in the line of bhakti. So they are shuddhi. So this Gita is for them, for primary stage. That you are not, this body is not myself, our mind is not ourself. You should tolerate all the worldly things. And you should think that I am part and parcel of Krishna. Mamai vanso jiva loke jivbhuta sanatana. Be sthiti pragya. Sthiti pragya means? What is the meaning of sthiti pragya? What?
Understanding.
That I am soul, part and parcel of Krishna. We have nothing to do with worldly things. We should not be attached in worldly things. Be fixed. Fix your mind in Krishna consciousness. This is sthiti pragya. If sukh and dukh, hani, maran, jivan, labh, that death and birth, suffering and sorrows, hotness and coldness, all kinds of suffering may come. You should tolerate. These are for very few moments. So you should tolerate and always engage your mind, your body, your soul, everything in Krishna consciousness. All your senses. He is telling to engage, but not engaged still. And if we will offer all practices and everything to the lotus of feet of Krishna, surrendering ourselves, then Krishna easily may give all these things. And he will make us enter in bhakti realm. But our effort will not do. Our effort is very weak, but Krishna will is so strong. In a moment he can turn anyone. So we should not have so much faith on our activities in our sadhana bhajan, but we'll have faith on Krishna. If you are avoiding the rules of Vedic culture, giving of wife, giving of sons, giving of husband, give him your Gurudev if he is not in helping mood. No harm, Krishna is telling that I will excuse everything. You should take shelter in me. So, Nigama Kalpataro Rugali. Sarva Upanishado Gavo. Only the extracts of Upanishad is Gita. Understand? Sarva Upanishado Gavo Dugdha Gopala Nandana. The teachings of all the Upanishad about Tattva. Who am I? Who is Krishna? Who is Brahma? What is Yogamaya? What is Mahamaya? What is Bhakti? What is Illusory Maya? All these things. But in his Upanishad, very rare are explaining Krishna Bhakti, Krishna Prem. Very few, like Gopal Tapani Upanishad. Not so much. And all tells, oh, Mukti is our supreme object.
Ultimate goal.
So we don't follow practically Upanishads in our Rasa Upasana. Only to know who am I, we are not worldly things, our body is not myself, we are part and parcel of Krishna. We should not engage our senses in being attached to worldly things. This is Upanishad. So, Sarva Upanishad, Sam and Substance are all is. So it has been called Gita Upanishadam. Gita is like Upanishad. But for Srimad Bhagavatam, Nigam Kalpataror Galitam, compare this slope. Nigam Kalpataror. Nigam means whole Vedas, including all Upanishads, including all Purans. Mahabharata also, abstract of Mahabharata, abstract of Gayatri, Om. Everything is Srimad Bhagavatam. Partly Gita, but in a whole, Krishna Sarup is Srimad Bhagavatam. Krishna has himself told that Srimad Bhagavatam, myself is Srimad Bhagavatam. What a shlok? Kya shlok? Ja Krishna. Tamadi devam karuna nidharnam, tamal varanam suhidavataram, apar sansar samudra setum, bhajamahe Krishna Bhagavatam Krishna swarupam. For Gita it has been not told. 12th canto is the 12 parts of Krishna. In Gita, Krishna Prem, how anyone loves Krishna, it has not clear there. So it is primary book. So Vyas was not satisfied, even he has compiled Mahabharata. So Srimad Bhagavata is more superior. It is for whom? Not graduate in this world, postgraduate in Krishna Prem. So Narad Goswami told Vyasadeva, you have met so many Purans and all these things. You have taught everything, all tats. In Gita he has told so many tats. In Puran, so many tats. So he has told, in Mahabharata, all tats has been given. But what is Prem? And who is the head personality of Godhead, Supreme Personality? You have told in other Purans that Ganesh, having the head of
Elephant
is superb from personality. Somewhere we have told like Shiva is supreme personality of Godhead. Sometimes telling in that Durga is supreme personality. You have confused all. Someone are confused that all are same. So you should establish truth. Don't
confuse
anyone. Especially, you have not told how Krishna is controlled, how he is so much pleased to anyone. You have not told. You have not told anywhere how Srimad Bhagavat, Krishna is ocean of rasa. When Krishna is ocean of rasa, being Brahma, Parabrahma, is not a son of Rashi. When he is with associates of Vaikuntha, he is a son of Rashi? No, he is not a son of Rashi. He is the son of opulence. So much. But you should also know that being in Dwarka, he the ocean of affluence is more than Narayan and anyone. But it can dive in the ocean of Madhur. Understand? Himalaya is so high, but it can sink in Pacific Ocean, so deep. So like Pacific Ocean is Madhur Ras, and Himalaya is like opulent. Is it like in Braja, opulent is like go to Haridwar. Ganges is coming. And give 100 bags of salt in Ganges in Haridwar. And common now in Calcutta, in Hooghly River, where he is going to meet with sea. Will you test some saltish in that water?
No.
No. Why?
Gone.
Water is so, such endless water there, that 10 and 1,000 bags of salt is nothing for that. So, Dwarka has more opulence than Vaikuntha. But in Vrindavan, Mathuras is so deep, like Pacific Ocean, more than Pacific Ocean, that the Himalayan of opulence sinks there. No trace at all. Covered totally. In Braja there are so many opulence. So you have not expanded all these things anywhere in Gita. So you should try to expand. Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead indeed. But he is controlled by Prem. Prem is more superior than Radha and Krishna. Prem makes dance to Krishna and Radha and all gopis. Their prominence is Prem. Do you understand? Understanding this? In Braja, Krishna is not supreme, but Krishna Prem is supreme. By this Prem makes dance to Krishna, to gopis, to Yashoda and all. So our mool object is Krishna Prem. Krishna Prem Prayojan. Anywhere it has not told that Krishna is Supreme Goal. Krishna Prem is Supreme Goal. If you have not that Prem, you cannot serve Krishna. You cannot serve Srimati Radhika. So there should be prominency of Krishna Prem. In Srimad Bhagavat it has been established. Krishna sometimes goes to Javat. He has changed his dress. He has become like
a student,
beggar student, having sacred thread on sandal. Wooden sandal, having
umbrella
of
palm leaves,
and some box here, and telling that,
Alak Niranjan.
What is Alak Niranjan?
None can see.
Personalist, like
impersonalist.
No shape, no attributes, no shakti, power, no qualities at all. That is Alak Niranjan. Anyone cannot see him. Anyone cannot realize him. He is not so much merciful. No quality in him. That is called Alakshana, like Mayavadis. No? So he was telling like Alak Niranjan, that anyone comes to give me alms. Went to the door of Jatila Kutila and began to shout like this. Jatila came and wanted to give something to him, like atta,
flowers,
or rice, dal, ghee, and all other things. Because it was so morning, and if in that time, if you are not giving anything to beggar, then you lose so much thing. So Krishna was shouting, and he was telling that I will not stay more than 5 minutes. A cow should be milked. Only that time I will give. Otherwise I will go. And then if anyone is not giving me, then he will have to lose so many things. Especially cows. It may be that the owner of house will die. The wives will be widow, women will be widow, and so many things. Wealth will go away. So she was hurried, Jatila. She came with alms, but Krishna refused. Why refused? I don't know whether you are yod or what thing. Only I take with
married
ladies. Then he went to Radhika and he told that you should come and you should give all. Because he is very shining student. And having so many qualities, you should certainly come and give. Repeatedly he told, but he is refused. I don't want to see the mouth of any, appearance of any other
male.
Then he requested Vishakha and Lalita that you should make agree that Srimati Radhika should go. They requested Srimati Radhika. Then she was ready. She took all these things there. And he was giving to Krishna, but having bell
covered.
Krishna told, I don't take bhiksha like this. I should see who are you are not.
Female,
what you are.
Then
he was giving, having some bell upside. Krishna told, refused again. I went only that you are angry with me. I want your this in my
bags.
You will be pleased to me. For this I have come to you. Hearing this, Srimati Radhika smiled something and gave all these things on the head of Krishna. And she returned. Have you anywhere written all these things? That he is controlled, he begging to being Supreme Personality of Godhead and begging to Radhika, sometimes Yashoda chastising him, and he is weeping so much. Have you written all these things? Krishna is telling, Napareham niravatya sanjujan sasadu kritya bibhujajusavi ma bhajana durujara griha singhala sambrishya sadava pratijata sadhuna. Krishna is telling himself, I cannot repay you. Your everything is so pure. Your meeting with me is so pure. Even Narad, Shankar, Vyasa, Sukadeva Goswami cannot touch your lotus feet dust. They cannot. I have repaid to mother, father, everyone, friends, but I cannot repay you. Why? If I will tell that you should tell any benediction you want, I will give you. You will tell that Please give your service. And if I am giving my service, again I am becoming
indebted
to you. He could not satisfy Nrisimhadev Prahlad Maharaj even. He wanted to give so much benediction, but he refused. I told here or in England, the
England.
Dialect between gopis and Krishna. I will tell in proper time. So, Krishna cannot repay them. So, Narada has not explained all these things. Especially, you should see that when Krishna went to Mathura, and from there he went to Vrindavan. Gopis were feeling so much separation and they became mad. But what was the condition of Krishna at that time? What was? Can you realize anything? Who was more feeling separation mood? Krishna or gopis? How? Because gopis has so many friends, lakhs and lakhs. They can distribute their this separation to all. No? But Krishna has no friend like this. Even Uddhava is not qualified to hear all these things. He cannot share Krishna separation mood. So Krishna was so much upset at that time. If anyone is more feeling separation, he would send any message to anyone. Gopis has not sent any messenger to Krishna in Dwarka or Mathura. But Krishna has sent. Why? He wanted the mercy of gopis. He was feeling more separation because there was no one to share Krishna, console Krishna. But Lalita and Vishakha always giving consolation to Radhika. Why you are so worried? We are also here. Srimati Radhika is telling. When it happened in that Leela, Gambhira Leela, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, dialoguing with Sab Damodar Narad, thinking them Lalita and Vishakha. I am dying, Srimati Radhika is telling. And you are consoling me, pacifying me. When I become faint, it is remedy for me. But when I faint, you give water and you try to make me
incense.
Why you do so? I think you are enemy of me. Why you are? Let me be faint. So I will not feel so much separation. I will die. Who consoles to anyone? Who is going to pacify anyone? Who has less?
Said.
Less?
Separation.
Like a woman is weeping for his son, he is dead. And he is bitterly crying for his son. Neighbors comes and pacify him. That don't weep or don't show. This is the nature of this world. But if his son is dead, then what he will do? So Lalita and Vishakha are helping Srimati Radhika. They have no separation mode like Radhika. So there is none in Mathura to satisfy Krishna, to pacify or help. That is why he sent Uddhava. Messenger came from Krishna to gopis because Krishna needed more thing. Gopis are telling that If Krishna forgets us, why we cannot forget Krishna? Tell Uddhava to Krishna that gopis are already forgotten. He should be very happy with Jadav women's, wives of Jadavs. He should pacify one, and another will be anger, and he will go to another. Another will be angry. So lakhs and lakhs Jadav Rani is there, and he will whole day and night, whole his days he will be pacified. Why to remember us? Krishna sometimes remember us that gopis are not so sweet like you are, like Rukmini Shaktabhama. Gopis are not beautiful. Or sometimes he remembers us that, oh, gopi prepared so much, so good garland, they cannot do. In any way he, and telling, so they become fainted, rolling down on the earth. Have you all this explained anywhere? I said, never, I have not done so. So you should write all. How can I write? Take the shelter of bhakti. Bhakti yoge manasi samyak panihite amale apashyat purusham purnamayam cha jad apashyam. He took the shelter of bhakti yoga. How many minutes?
45 minutes.
Achha. Then, what he saw? Apashyat purusham purna. Dwarkadhish is not Purna. He is Purna, but not Purnatar, not Purnatam. Dwarkadhish is Purna. And Mathuresh is Purnatar. And Krishna is
Vrajananandan Purnatam.
Purnatam. Somewhere you will see that Swamiji has told that he took birth in Mathura. Actually, Vasudev and Dwarka, Devaki were the father and mother of Krishna. Nanda is what father?
Foster
father. Why he told? Why he told? There are two groups. One group of Mathura and one group of Vrindavan, Braja. All the Brahmans, Vasudev Devaki, Akrur Uddhav, all the Jadavs are in the opinion that Krishna is the son of Vasudev. But gopis, Nandava, Jasoda, any friend of Krishna, any creeper of Vrindavan, any mosquito of Vrindavan, even ants, they cannot believe that Krishna is son of Vasudev and Dev. If you are in the party of Mathura, then you can believe that he is son of Vasudev. And if you are in the side of Braja, then you will see that Krishna is the son of
Nanda.
Then you should keep your hands here and decide yourself. You are Mathuravasi or Brajavasi? Uddhava is one side. Although most intelligent and very dear in Dwarka and Mathura to Krishna. No? And gopis are here in Vrindavan. Two parties. One party is gopis. And another party is Uddhav, Akrur, and all others. They have this argument that Krishna is the son of Vasudeva. But you see that Uddhav is praying, Asamaho charanarenu jushamaham syam brindavane kimap gul malatau sadhina jadu sajang sajanayar japatan chahitva bheje mukunda padaving shruti bhi I want to be the dust of lotus flower of gopis.
Lotus feet.
Dust of the lotus feet of gopis. Not all dusts I am not qualified to do. I want to pray only one
particles.
I want to be. Oh, he thought, and oh, I am not qualified to be a dust. Even so, I am praying for very far away that lotus dust of gopis, so rare, so high. Without the mercy of gopis, anyone cannot realize that Krishna, ocean of rush, and what is he? He is Supreme Personality of Godhead. So who are among Akrur and Uddhav and other party gopis who are reliable source? Who are Praman? Praman means?
Evidence.
Gopis are evidence or Uddhav is evidence?
He's authentic.
Authentic. Who is authentic? Even Uddhav is accepting that truth. So we should be in gopis, faiths. What gopis are telling, it is true to full extent, more than Krishna says anything. If Krishna established one thing and gopis are establishing one truth, we don't follow Krishna. We follow the gopis. So gopis are telling that Krishna is son of Jashoda and Nanda. Sometimes they become angry and tell that Nago khalu gopika nandano yayam artito vishwaguptaye vikhanasarthito vishwaguptaye sakhi udiyavan shashvatankule. Gopis are now upset and so much angry to Krishna, and they will be using Krishna. Certainly you are not the son of Jashoda. If you were the son of Jashoda, you had not been so much cruel like this. Or certainly you are son of Kshatriya, Vasudeva and Devaki. That is why you are so cruel. So they are abusing Krishna. Actually they are not telling that. Nakhalu gopika nandano. They tell. Some are telling that. Oh, you are certainly the son of Jashoda. But why you become so cruel? Why you become? So, now we are telling that you are not son of Jashoda, you are Kshatriya and like that. Sometimes Nanda Baba also in separation mood can tell like this. If he was my son, why he has left me and he has gone to Mathura? There was only son and father. Ram was son, Dasarath was his father. When Ram went to
jungle,
Dasarath Maharaj told Ram, Ram, Ra and left. Not monk came and he left his body. I'm not like Dasarath. Why I'm living? I'm not qualified to be a son, father of Krishna. Krishna is so lovely, but I'm not qualified, sir. That is, he has left him. And he has elected or chosen another father. Because Vasudeva is more superior than me. But these are in separation, not in actual position. So you have you explained all these things? Oh, wonderful, wonderful. Vasudeva is telling. I'll have to realize all these truths. Never I have written. Never I realize. How can I realize? This apashyata purusham purna. He saw everything. He saw all these things in samadhi and realized these facts. Jasya vaisuryamanayam krishne paramapuruse bhakti rupapadyate punsa soka moha bhayapaha. I have did Srimad Bhagavatam from my samadhi. And one who will read this Bhagavatam with a special guru, very qualified, tattvajna, and being rasik and bhavuk, then anyone can understand this prem. Otherwise he cannot realize. Because it is the book of postgraduate, not primary book. So he realized all these truth and compiled Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavat came in his samadhi stays. And what he saw, and he related all in Srimad Bhagavatam. And he became so wonderful. And his faith increased in Narad, that he has helped me in all these things. So in like ways, if any guru develops your Krishna prem, gives any very little spark or a sprinkle of this thing, greed, then we should see that, so much faith will come to that guru. So we should know all these things. A kirtan should be done after that. A ghanta ho gaya? Kirtan. Namami Nandanandanam. In a line. Namami What is the what do you know about how Jai Vijay was fell down from Vaikuntha, and he has to take 3 births as the demon? Anyone can explain how? What is the mystery about this?
The 4 Kumaras had come to the doors of the gateway of Vaikuntha, and they were wanting to enter in, and Jai and Vijay, being the gatekeepers, had stopped them at that time.
You should hear patiently. If anything question comes, later on we will speak.
And in this way, they had committed a Vaishnava aparad. So Lord Narayan, he knew at this time that they had committed such an offense. So he came to that place and he attempted to save his servitors.
Yes.
But at that time, the 4 Kumaras had cursed them to take birth within the material world. But it was also the desire of the Lord to come into the material world and perform his pastimes, his leelas.
Very good. Anyone can clear more? Ball?
Well, they had a rather unfortunate choice. They could take 3 births as demons, or they could take 7 births of as devotees. Once they were in very small, childlike bodies, maybe 5 years old, and they were naked. This is the reason the guards at the gates of Vaikuntha, they would not take them seriously. I thought, what is this? You have no qualification to come in. This little children like this, not even properly dressed. And that's why they have to, you know, curse him to go away. But they actually very highest quality learned scholars who are staying in this little boy-sized body because they're not wanting to be disturbed by the senses. Not wanting to be disturbed coming into the old years, and the influx of agitation from the senses is coming. So they're thinking, no, I don't want to be like that. So this is just some trick of their mystic, very high mystic yoga power. By such a trick, they're staying in this little sized body. So they remain undisturbed. But the gatekeeper somehow or other, under yoga maya, because this is within Krishna's pastime, they're not understanding these things. I think there's some ordinary phenomena. So they said, to mitigate the situation, Lord Vishnu says, well, curse has been given, I'm not going to withdraw, but you can take a choice whether you go for 3 births as my devotees, or 7 births as my devotees, or 3 births you can go as demons. But because they're very learned scholars saying, oh, this material world is a terrible place, and this samsara, this repeated birth and death, this is very terrible, very horrible. So better to go 3 births as a demon than 7 births as devotees. Very nice to be devotee, but better to get out of that place as fast as possible. So they say, all right, we'll take 3 births as a demon. But there is one secret why the Supreme Person should want to prefer to, you could say, card trick, they say, stacking the deck to make it in such a way that they should make a decision to go as demons instead of as devotees, because they should go as demons because this desire for having some fight, this is also within the Supreme Person. So he is wanting to carry out this leela of having some fight. But he cannot fight with any ordinary person, must be only with his devotee. Mm-hmm. So he is taking some trick so that he has to fight with his, so he'll fight with his devotees. So they say, oh, yes. All right, we'll go as devotees. So he's coming then, so they're coming down in the 3 different births, one on Aranyakasipu and Aranyakshak, and isn't it in Krishna Lila's coming with the
Dantabakra.
So this way,
He's fighting with his devotees for it. Very nicely.
Very. I'm satisfied with your question, answer. But still, iho bhajya aage kohar. What?
Somewhat external.
Something.
That is external. Speak
can
more.
You tell? Very
brief,
not going so detail.
One day God was thinking that I have tasted so many mellows, not beer rus. So he want to taste beer rus. In scripture there is one slok, natasya karyam karanancha vidyate, natat samasabhadika sadhisyate. None is equal to God, and what to say more than him. So God is thinking that no one is equal to me, so to whom I can fight, that I can test Vidras. In Vaikuntha, no one is conditioned from there, everybody is liberated, his associates also liberated. Jai Vijay know the heart of his Prabhu, and they are thinking, oh, if I fight with my Prabhu, then it is like a drama. So if I will be quite opposite of my Prabhu, then we can fight with him, then he can test Vidras. Knowing the mood of Narayan, Jogmaya attracts four Kumars to Vaikuntha. Krishna, Narayan desire, then Jogmaya want to fulfill his desire, so he attracts four Kumars. Four Kumars came and want to enter Vaikuntha. But Jai Vijay don't allow to go enter. Oh, you don't know how to camp Vaikuntha, you are quite naked, you know nothing, the courtesy of Vaikuntha. Then they think, oh, you are gatekeeper of Vaikuntha, there is no fear here, there is no Kuntha Dharma. Why you
stop
us here? So you are not be qualified to stay here, so we have to go material world. Then you can understand that what is the quality of qualification to go enter in Vaikuntha. You have to do so many performance, then you can come again. That in the meantime, God Narayan came and told, oh, this fault of my servant is my fault, please excuse me. And he take out his Jogmaya. Then four Kumars came to know that, oh, we have done mistake. Then people, no, you have not done mistake, this is my fault, this is my servant fault, this is my fault. God want to take test Vidras, so it has happened like this. And Srila Vishwanathya Thakur is explaining about this, giving his vision about this point, that Jai Vijay never fell down from Vaikuntha. Being in shape of Jai Vijay, they are in Vaikuntha, and they came in shape of, for three words, Hiranyakasipu Hiranyaksha, and Ravan Kumbhakarna, and Shishupal Dantavakra. Srila Chakra Thakur told, this is a prem vijjin vid chesta of Srila Bhagavan. It is not fall down from Vaikuntha like that jeev came from Karana Sai Vishnu, and they are testing material world, not same thing. So due to desire of God, so they came in this world to fulfill Prabhu's desire, not there for their self sense gratification. Hare Krishna.
Bahut.
Because none can fall down from Vaikuntha.
Once Narad came in the courtyard of Yashoda Devi. Krishna was rolling down on the earth and weeping. And he was shouting that, Mother, 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 I want to go in your laps. But Yashoda was doing that. Oh, naughty boy, I will not take you in my laps. Narad saw. And he's telling that, oh, how this wonder. the supreme personality of Godhead, Krishna has come as a child, as a baby, to the womb of Yashoda, and she is controlling, and she is rebecoming that Krishna. Then he came in front of Yashoda. Yashoda at once took the feet dust of
Narada.
And he took his boy and he
make him fell in the lotus feet of
on the lotus feet of
Narada Rishi.
Narada. And he took the feet dust of Narada Rishi and doing this and that. Narada is superior or Yashoda is superior? Narada, no? Because Yashoda is taking? Who is superior?
Yashoda.
Why she is taking the foot dust of Narada Rishi? Narada Rishi knows all these facts. And thinks himself, I should not disturb this Yashoda. He is much superior than me in like koti guna. Koti guna means?
Crore times
she is better. She is observed in Vatsalya Rasa. I can never taste. I cannot be a foot dust of Yashoda. He is realizing this, Narada Rishi, because he is Jnani Bhakta somewhat. Knowing the opulence of Krishna, Yashoda never thinks of Krishna affluent, always thinking that he is my child, my son. So she is rebuking and doing so. Take this impression and we should go to Vaikuntha. And there we see that Chatushan is going to Vaikuntha. Who is superior? Always serving Narayan, are sometimes luckily going there to take darshan of Narayan. Chatushan is occasionally, sometimes, rarely he goes, enters in Vaikuntha and only takes darshan of Narayan. But Jai Vijay?
Always serving
in by all means. So who are superior? Jai Vijay, so much higher. Chatushan very rare have chance to go to, and he has never served Narayan, only praying. What praying? Shantakarang bhuja yagasayanam padmanabham suresham, like this. Not serving, but always they are serving. So they are supreme.
Superior
to Chatushan. Yogmaya called Chatushan there. And to realize the glory of Jai and Vijay and all, they cannot do any offense there. No place of offense. Offense comes from Mahamaya. Mahamaya has no a little space in
Vaikuntha.
She lives where? Out of this Karnabdisha, mane kya?
Biraja.
He never crosses Biraja. Always there, Yogmaya. Anyhow, he has a very, very sacred occasion to go enter Vaikuntha. They wanted to please Narayan. They knew that Narayan wants to test Bira Rasa. How we can do? Anyhow, we want to satisfy your Prabhu. Chatushan cannot do. They cannot think like so. Narayan knew this fact. called Yogamaya, and he called also Chatushan there. Chatushan became some angry by the behavior of
Jayavijaya.
But Jayavijaya never done any mistake or anything. They can go to hell to please their Prabhu. Like Vasudev told lie to Kansa that I have a daughter only. I should go to hell, no harm, but I should fulfill my
purpose.
So Jayavijaya was in this thought. Chatushan cannot reach to this level. When they will be like this, then they will go to Vaikunth forever. But luckily they have entered there. And only by the help of Yogamaya, Yogamaya has called. When Narayan took Yogamaya, we have done mistake. We see that Jayavijaya has never done any offense. So we should not think that any jeev can come from Vaikuntha, will fall from there, and do any mistake and wrong and anything. What? Offense there. No offense there. Nothing. If Sridham Subal Madhumangal sits on the shoulder of Krishna and telling that, oh horse, go on, and giving something. Oh, my horse is not running, so
horse.
Then give some like slap to Krishna. This is very big offense. It is to please Krishna. Gopis are telling that we are tired, you should massage our feet. And Krishna gently comes and massages. This is offense. It is out of the amazing of Sanakshanandan and Sanatan. So we should try to know all these facts. He wanted to satisfy his Prabhu, and that is why he can do anything. Our Prabhupada Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati has told, to obey our holy masters or Gurudev, I can cut lakhs and lakhs persons. He has not done so, but it is the nishtha. It is the faith. Nishtha. More than faith. Not faith. It is nishtha. In the lotus feet of Gurudev. What? This is the fact. Krishna wanted to come in this world. Why? Krishna, Narayan. To help conditioned souls. And he wanted to make so many pastimes here, so that all conditioned soul will learn, will hear our katha, and thus they will come towards me. So Jayavijaya has helped this. They have part the play of like a conditioned soul, but they were not conditioned soul. Anyway, coming in the shape of demons, not like so. I have not heard that story of my Prabhu that told that in seven devotees were
demon
and demon. I have not heard or read this story. But it may be, for example, to say, to what? To
glorify.
No. To make entheogies, to inspire bhakts only. Actually, always Jayavijaya serves him there. And in one shape he came here. Not only two shapes, lakhs and lakhs shapes in lakhs and lakhs worlds. Krishna Leela is past time going everywhere. So Jabija became lakhs and lakhs. We cannot enter in these things. Brahma has told, Janantu, Janantu, King Bhaktvami na Prabho, Manisho Bapusho Bhasha Tava Agosharam. Anyone can count the rays of sun. Anyone can count the rays of dust of whole world. Anyone can count the particles of
universe.
But anyone cannot count the pastimes of Krishna. And he cannot touch the glory of Krishna. Those who are telling like this, that I know, they are foolish. With four heads I cannot count anything. I don't know. Hare Krishna Gaur Premanande. Next we will tell next day. Any other kirtan? Meru Radha Raman. Munindra. Yeah. No. Munindra Vinda. thing I want to clear, that Biswanath Chakravarti Thakur in Madhurya Kadambini or any book, he has warned us not to think that Chitraketu Maharaj being liberated, again he fall down in this world and became Vritrasu. And for Jai Vijay that they have fall down from Vaikuntha and they have become Hiranyakashipu, Hiranyaksha, Raman, Kumbhakaran or Shishupala. Don't feel like that. If you are doing that, you are doing
offense.
No? So we must be careful. He has told that if it is any jeev can fall any time from Vaikuntha, then what is the need of doing so much sadhan bhajan? Even in sadhan bhajan, in bhava avastha, there is no tendency to make any
offense.
He becomes out of all
offenses
and unearths. In Vaikuntha, how it will come unearth and offenses there? This place is not a sadhan sthali, the place of sadhana. So anyone, a jeev, cannot fall down from there. Then if falling down, Jai Vijay and Chatraketu from there, that it may be that Srimati Radhika fall down. Also Krishna can fall down. Also we see that Lalita has fall down and Subal has fall down. You should not think like this. I'm thanking to my dear friend Gaur Govinda Maharaj, one of the most prominent disciple of Swamiji. He was in line of Swamiji. I can tell it very
boldly.
He never feared to anyone. Very frank and true speaker. He has established this truth by so taking so many arguments from Jiva Goswami, from Srimad Bhagavatam, for Gita, from Gita, that yadagatvana nivartante, where going and never returns, fall down. He can return with Swami, his Prabhu, to only play the past times, but not like falling down. So he has given so many arguments. I saw that his literature. I also glorify him in the line of Swamiji. Sometimes difference of opinion to Gaur Govinda Maharaj and other disciples. They wanted to choke his mouth. Choke. You should not speak all these things. I will speak and forever I will establish this. He never cared for anything. So if he want to do bhajan, whole world is one side and I am alone in one side. Don't care anything. Only that care for Shuddha Bhakti and Shuddha Vaishnavas, not for these things. So he was so bold. He has given so many literatures also. I have read it. And I have so much near and dear to him. When I went to Puri, he met me about 5-6 months before he left this world. And he was so near to me that he told his disciples that you can hear Harikatha from Narayan Maharaj. So he was surely in the line of Swamiji. Such disciples are very rare. So I appreciate him. He has written all these things. All arguments that I used to give, he has taken from Shastra. So Swamiji, for beginners, he has told, like Chaitanya Charitamrita has told, no doubt, that Krishna Bholi Sei Jiva Anadir Bahirmukh. Jiva has forgotten. When forgotten? Oh, he must be in Vaikuntha, and from there he has forgotten. He has not explained in beginning. But he has, what's the opinion that he, I have read so many his books, Krishna books, and so many books. He has everywhere established that any jeev cannot return, cannot fall from Vaikuntha and he will learn. So you should be in the same opinion that any jeev cannot fall from Vaikuntha. If he falls, then it is not Vaikuntha, it is material place. Then anyone can
fall down from
fall
there.
Down. So it is not true. So Swamiji has told this. I also tell like this. Krishna boli jai, no harm. But we will have to see just that what he told more. He has told more so many times that jeev never falls from Vaikuntha. And for beginners, some very little occasion he has told that they were in Vaikuntha. No harm. We'll have to reconcile his mood.
You said the moon in the tree.
Eh?
The moon in the branches of the tree.
Yes, like this.
Shakachandra.
So we should reconcile all these things, where we'll see difference of opinion in our acharya. In same one acharya, sometimes writing like this, sometimes we'll have to reconcile. Otherwise, we make
offense.
Gau Pramana.
Mahamantra.
You should do anyone.
Govinda.